Better late than never, right? Lamb of God is the latest release from Lamb of God, released on June 19th, 2020. They've always been a band I really liked, but I've never done a true deep dive. I've heard every album for the most part, but the last time I was supposed to see them live, the show was canceled. I've always been a big fan of their sound, and they created one of my favorite riffs of all time from Till the End. But none of that really matters. How is their most recent release? Let's find out together, shall we? Here we go. I am a big speaker on the importance of atmosphere in music, and the beginning of this song just oozes it. I can picture you walking down the moonlit hallways of a creepy old mansion that, boom, just get double bass kicked in the face as it reminds you of who you're listening to. It's nothing out of the ordinary for them, but after the intro they did, it hits different. I do like that breakdown though. I like it a lot. This is the first song we heard from this album. This song landed on my playlist the first time I heard it because it is good. That bluesy intro is too sexy not to. The structure of the verse is great in its diversity of speeds. Randy's screams are on full display in that chorus, with a great play on words. It's another song that follows their formula, but it's one of the best examples of said formula. Different sort of intro here, with a guitar riff on the drum roll. The riff in the verse sounds somewhat familiar, but it has little notes here and there that make it seem a little more fresh. Pre-chorus and the chorus itself are just very satisfying. They have a build-up quality that just works quite well. The solo itself is okay, but I much prefer the rhythm that's actually going on underneath. That riff rocks. We are back to that haunted house feeling in the intro, for a bit. Because then the verse just picks up the pace and, well, me like. I was feeling the flow of a somewhat chill haunt, but the pedal of metal is the best. It gets your head bobbing. I really enjoyed the back and forth nature of this song. Keeps it unpredictable and separates itself from the others. It's my favorite song so far. Let's spread a little hate worldwide. I think this may be the most moshable song so far. Closing my eyes, I can just really picture one of those great live shots of music festivals. Man, I miss concerts. The bridge and breakdown really cement this song as the main mosher so far. Resurrection F, I mean Man, is up next. Starts kinda creepy, like a porcelain doll. Then the doll goes blah! This is the heaviest song so far. I mean, hot damn, you can feel it pushing you down. We have hit a great pocket in this album, because the last three songs have sounded very different, but all very good. There's a drum fill at about the 2.5 minute mark that just really stood out to me. The bridge and the riff right after it just scream for a Running Man circle pit. And then right when you're done with that is a part that's clearly meant to start a wall of death, with its diminished notes and heavy stomp on your soul. This song is just spectacular. Featuring Jamie Josta. There's something old school about just starting the song with the unfiltered guitar riff. It also helps when it's a great riff. I like the stop in the riff post-chorus as well. I don't have much to say in this song other than the riffs are great. Jamie also adds a really good dimension to the vocals here. Even though his solo part is kind of okay, it's good, but I don't know if it actually fits. Other than the riff for this song is a little thin, but the guitar work here is top notch to counteract that. Before we get to the last few songs of this album, I have a goal of reaching 100 subscribers before the end of this year. If you're enjoying this video or any of my past videos and are not yet subscribed, please consider doing so. Help me reach this goal. I'll be eternally grateful. This song has a bit of a testament-y vibe to it, which makes sense because Chuck Billy is here. And when he comes in, ooh, it's nice. Thrash metal is my favorite style of metal, and this song is a great example of thrash. This song is short, sweet, and to the point of greatness. Got some Randy singing clean, and I'm one of the ones who feels his clean voice is highly underrated. Randy is really the only part of the song I like though, the rest of it's just kinda there. Even when the guitar tries to pick it up, it's just too generic to elevate it any further than it actually is, as the weakest song of the album. We are ending this race on a sprint. This song sounds very akin to early Lamb of God, and saving that style of song for the end of the album is a good idea in my head. It leaves all the fans happy. It's another song that really changes up its style, but remains cohesive enough so it doesn't lose you. It's a great song to close out the album. This album is pretty great, but there's really nothing new, save for a few fantastic moments that really sets it apart. There are some songs here that will definitely remain on my rotation. One thing that is abundantly clear though, they are missing Adler. The only time the drums really stuck out to me was when I mentioned that fill. Otherwise, they're just kind of there. Solid, but there. Overall, if you somehow have not listened to this album yet or have not heard Lamb of God before, I would say give this one a spin. This is Fenrirock signing off. Take care.